Hey everyone, in today's video I'm going to be sharing with you my makeup recommendations for spring. So the makeup that really inspires me, that really makes me excited for spring, and just the ones that I think about when I think about spring, the ones that I really want to wear, and I'm really excited to share these with you guys. So let's get right into the video. So if you haven't been on my channel before, my name is Marley and I love making YouTube videos about makeup and beauty. I love doing looks, swatches, reviews, will I buy it videos, all that kind of stuff. So if that sounds good to you, then don't forget to subscribe. I usually upload about 2 to 3 videos a week and I would love to see you again on my channel. So I have a bunch of different products here in front of me. I have some eyeshadow palettes, blushes, highlighter, some lip products, perfumes, nail polish. I just kind of picked a few things for every category because spring doesn't just make me excited for eyeshadow palettes, it also really makes me excited for certain blushes, lip products. I've already seen a lot of these videos going around and I just wanted to share my favorites with you guys. So let's start with some blushes. I have 3 blushes here in front of me. The first blush that I picked for my spring favorites is this Clinique Pink Pop blush. This blush, just the whole aesthetic, the packaging, the color, like this bright pink that has some coralness to it, that is a little bit like watermelony colored. This just really makes me excited for warmer weather. I just love this embossing that it has with the flower. It's so cute. And then this color is just so flattering. I love it. It's amazing. I just love wearing this for a little bit of a fresh pinky blush on the cheeks. The finish is really natural, a little bit glowy. It's like this baked gelée formula. So it just looks very like glowy and pretty. And I just love the finish that this has. It doesn't have any shimmer at all, but it just looks very natural and glowy. And this one might look a little bit scary in the packaging, but on the cheeks it does look quite natural. At least on my skin tone it blends out quite well and it doesn't look like too bright. Next blush is kind of like a bonus product. This blush is the blush from Essence in the shade Breezy. This is one of the new products that I recently tried in my Essence and Catrice try-on haul. I only used this twice, once during that haul and once today. So this particular color I haven't tried a lot, but I do know that I really love this formula and I just think this new shade is really cute and really appropriate for spring because it's just like this really peachy orangey coral. It definitely has a lot of warmth to it, but it also has a little bit of a pink undertone. I think this is a really nice one if you like a little bit of a toned down coral blush. If you're more into warm toned blushes, then I think you will really like this. But also if you're more of a cool undertone and you just want to branch out a little bit, I think this is a great choice because it's really affordable and it still has a little bit of that pinky undertone when it comes to this coral shade. In some lights it looks pretty orange and then in other lights it looks quite coral. So this particular one I haven't used a lot, but this formula is just really pretty, really natural on the cheeks. It has a nice amount of pigmentation. It's not too lightly pigmented, but it definitely shows up on the skin. It's a matte, but it looks very natural. It doesn't look flat. It has a slight satiny sheen to it. So I think this is a great one for spring and summer. And I think I'm gonna be wearing this one a lot because it's just so nice and fresh. It just gives a little bit of warmth to your skin without looking too orange or overpowering because it just has this really nice corally undertone. The next blush I'm not going to be able to open without a tweezer. Give me a sec. So the next blush is a blush by Sleek. This is, I think, a UK indie brand. And this is a brand I've been using for years. I've been using their blushes for years, but this is like their new range. They updated their blushes. They added some different colors with different names. And I was really curious, so I tried this one. And this is a really nice kind of corally shade as well. It's kind of the same tone as that Essence blush, but this has some gold shimmer to it. So it doesn't just give your cheeks a really nice corally color, but it also has a nice golden sheen, and I just really love to have something like a sheen or a glow to a blush that you use in spring and summer. It just catches the light, like catches the sun so nicely. I don't know, glowy products just really make me think of better weather, like beautiful weather, being out in the sun. So I definitely wanted to mention a blush that is a little bit more glowy. This one is called Feeling Like a Snack. This is also a really affordable option. This is kind of, I think I paid like 4 euros for this one, so that's a really cheap. If you just want to try another blush, if you just want to branch out a bit for the season, but you don't know if you're gonna be wearing it a lot. So this is just a really nice corally pink. It's a little bit more pink than the Essence blush, and it just has a really nice sheen. It is on the pigmented side, but you can definitely build it up. It's not impossible to wear if you have fair skin. I'm pretty fair right now, and I've worn this and it looked really pretty. So you don't have to be like really tan to pull this off. It's not too pigmented. So next up, I only picked one highlighter, and I just think this is the perfect highlighter for spring and summer, and I think a lot of people will get away with this and a lot of people will like this type of formula. And this is a Nabla Skin Glazing in the shade Privilege, and this is just such a nice warm champagne. It has some pink to it, it has some peach to it, so it definitely adds some warmth to your skin. It isn't like too pale or icy. It's definitely not icy. Maybe it wouldn't work for like the fairest of fairest, then I wouldn't really recommend it. I don't think this would really work for people that are fairer than me, but if this works for you, it's so nice. It's such a nice color, but also such a nice finish. It just looks like your skin, but really glowy, really healthy. It just blends in so well. You can make it look really natural, but you can also build it up and make it quite blinding. It's what I'm wearing, and you can cut, and you can definitely see it on my cheeks. You can definitely see that glow, but it isn't like you can see where your highlighter begins and ends. It just all meshes in together, blends in together. It's so pretty. But I just really love this color. Just the peachiness that it has without being icy, just the warmth that it gives. I just love peachy highlighters and peachy cheek products in the spring and summer. I just think it's so nice and flattering, and I don't know, this just gives me all the vibes. When I think of a highlighter for spring, this is just the one thing I think about. I think this is just the perfect one for me. But if you're more fair than I am, or you're more tan than I am, then you can always check out the other highlighters that they have in their range, and then you can just go for something that has the same formula as this one, that just blends in so well and it's just really pretty and natural and glowy if you wanted to, or you can build it up. It's just so nice. I don't know what else I can say about it. It's just a perfect color and the perfect formula for me, and it just makes me so excited for beautiful weather, for the sun, for being out and about. It's just so nice. Then let's move on to some lip products. I picked out a few different ones. First up, I picked out the gloss that I'm wearing right now. This is the Nabla gloss in Stardust Radio. This is such a nice kind of peachy red gloss. It's just like a really warm red, but it's not too harsh and orangey. And also because it's see-through, it's really easy to wear, and it has this really nice golden shimmer throughout it that also makes it look so juicy and summery and shimmery. I just love the color of this gloss. It's just so flattering. There's something about like see-through red lips. I love that for the spring and summer. I just love how it looks. It's just such a nice way to add some color to your lips, but make it really wearable. I don't know, it's just so summery and nice. I just love these types of shades. And this formula also is so comfortable. It's so nice on the lips. It's very hydrating. And the scent, I don't know, it's like really nice and fruity, but it's not too overpowering. Like when you apply it, you're just like, that smells nice. But then now that I'm wearing it, I don't really smell it. And that's what I prefer with the lip product. I don't want the scent to be too overpowering, but I don't mind to smell it a little bit when I apply it and just be like, oh, that's nice. So if you like a little bit of a see-through red gloss with a bit of a shimmer in there, the shimmer isn't chunky, but you can see it on your lips, this is definitely one I would recommend. I'm just so excited to wear this the coming months. I just love the Nabla formula, but this shade is just exactly what I was looking for. This just gives me what I want for a gloss for spring and summer. This is definitely one of the products that I recommend the most. Then I have this NYX Lingerie Gloss in the shade Spirit. This one is also in my project pen, so I know I'm gonna be wearing it a lot the coming months. But this is just such a nice peachy, milky gloss. There isn't any shimmer in this one, but they have variations where they have like shimmer or glitter you can choose, but then it is the same color. So it kind of depends on what you want, but I just really like this kind of peachy, milky gloss, like creamy gloss for the spring and summer, because it's just a little bit more fresh. Because it has this kind of peachy pinkiness to it, it just looks so flattering and fresh and just more springy. I just love wearing lip products that are just a little bit more peachy. And I just think this is so easy to throw on. It's just so easy to wear with different kinds of looks. It works a bit like a nude lip product, but it just adds a little bit extra to your look. And that's what I like about it. Then I actually chose two lip products, two liquid lipsticks from Sephora collection. If you don't know yet, I'm really obsessed with these liquid lipsticks. This is my favorite liquid lipstick formula. I have so many of the shades, like so many. Maybe like 20? Like, there is no brand that made me buy so many lip products as Sephora. There's just something about this formula. They are not drying at all. They are just easy to apply. They are not too thick or too thin. They just stay on well. They stay on better than like a moussey liquid lipstick. And that's why I love these a little bit more than like the Ofra ones. I just think these have it all for me. And they are also very affordable. They are not the easiest for me to get a hold of because there's no Sephora in the Netherlands. But I have enough for now. And then sometimes when I go on like vacation or something, I will add a little bit more to my Sephora liquid lipstick collection. So I chose two shades. One is more cool toned, one is more warm toned. Of course, there are so many options and so many I could mention here, but I just wanted to mention the things that I thought of right away that really came up in my mind right away before I even looked at my collection and even looked at what I would recommend. So these are like my tippy top favorites for spring when it comes to the Sephora collection liquid lipsticks. So first up, this one. This one is like a nude, but it has a lot of peachiness to it. It is kind of slightly burnt, almost like a burnt terracotta, but lighter. So it still looks quite fresh on the lips. So if you're not into like a darker burnt terracotta look, you want something a little bit lighter and fresh, and this is such a nice one. This one is in a shade 70. It just looks so pretty on the lips and it gives you that peachy vibe without being too peachy. It still has a nude quality to it, so it's still quite easy to wear, but there is some brightness to it. So I wouldn't pair this with any look personally, because on me it looks quite peachy, but it's still definitely very wearable. You can wear it with different eye looks. You can even wear this a little bit more as a statement lip because it is more peachy. So I just really love how versatile it is, but still quite special and different than other like peachy nudes that I've tried. Then this is definitely my favorite pink in the Sephora collection, liquid lipstick collection. This one is really like cool tone, but still a bit toned down. And it isn't too purple. It's just a perfect pink for me that is quite of a statement lip, but not too much. This one is in the shade 55 and I just love wearing this one. There's just something about this one, just it just has the right amount of everything. Like, it isn't too cool, it isn't too warm, it isn't too bright, it isn't too dark. It's just really fresh and it just has a hint of warmth in it still that makes it really wearable and not too purple. So I just really love this shade. I think it's just so cute and it's just a nice one if you want to make a statement but you don't want it to be like neon and really bright. I would definitely recommend this color, but of course there are a lot of different shade variations in this collection. So if you want something a little bit darker, a little bit more peachy, whatever, then they have that as well. This is just my personal favorite and I would definitely recommend checking this out if you're looking for a pink liquid lipstick. So last up for the lips, I chose this Nabla Dreamy Creamy Liquid Lipstick in the shade Eve. I've already mentioned this quite a few times on my channel, but this is just such a nice pinky peach nude, but it's really glossy, so it looks really juicy on the lips, very healthy, and there's just something really fresh and nice about this one. It is quite a light nude, but on me it just has this really nice undertone that's somewhere in between pink and peach, but there's also some nude quality to it. I just think this is a really flattering shade and it just looks so pretty and fresh. I feel like I'm saying those words like throughout this whole video a lot, but that's just really what I love in spring and summer, like things that are pretty and fresh and just have a little bit of an extra brightness to it with a little bit of pinkiness or peachiness. I just think that's really nice, so I would definitely recommend this one. Then let's move on to the eyeshadow palettes. I try to keep it a little bit, I try to not pick too much, so I ended up with 4 eyeshadow palettes and like a duo. So first up, I think these single eyeshadows from Give & Glow are so nice for this time of year. Like these periwinkle shades, this shimmer is just gorgeous. I love the matte. I just love this little duo. I just think it's so cute and you can really make an easy, quick look that is still very colorful and not too harsh. Like, just this is just like the easiest colorful look. Just put the matte in the crease, the shimmer on the lid, and you're good to go. I just think these have such a nice pigment, such nice colors. If you are looking for periwinkle eyeshadows, then I would definitely recommend checking these ones out. Of course, you also have the Blueberry Muffin Palette by BH Cosmetics. That's also one that I would definitely recommend, but I feel like that one is a little bit less springy, summery, because it's combined with these more darker purpley brownie shades. But then I look at this a little duo, then I definitely get excited for spring. Then a favorite that I feel like I can't mention enough, maybe if you've seen a lot of my videos then you're like, of course she's talking about that again, but the Strawberry Shake palette from Colourpop is just such an underrated palette, so I just want to talk about it as much as I can because I feel like more people should know how good this one is. The quality is amazing, you have a lot of variation. Like, usually with the Colourpop monochromatic palettes you don't have the most variation, but here you have peaches, you have pinks, you have more kind of red tones that really elevate the look when you deepen up the look with them. You can go really bright, really soft, more nude, more peachy, more pink. You have so many options and the quality is great. I love the shimmers in this. I just think the colors are so cute. I just love doing like a peachy look or a pinky look with this. It doesn't have to be too crazy colorful. I think both color lovers and neutral lovers would enjoy a palette like this. This is just such a good one and I can't recommend it enough. So probably you're gonna hear me talk about this palette a few more times on my channel. It's just so underrated and it's just such a good one. This was also the first place in my Colourpop ranking video, so that says something. Then I also wanted to mention Colourpop Lilac You a lot. This is just such a nice lilac palette. You have a lot of different lilac options. Beautiful shimmers that really are all different, so you have a lot of options with that. I do create looks with this that are different from each other. It's not like all the same. It kind of depends on what you do. You can make it a bit more dark. You can make it a bit more like toned down, a little bit more nude. Like if you apply this shade to your eye, it definitely becomes a little bit more mauvey. So I really enjoy this palette. It just has such a nice quality. I really love working with these mattes. I really enjoy the shimmers. They are just really like nicely shifty. They all have some nice shift to them and they are quite creamy. I just really enjoy working with this palette. I just really enjoy these tones. If you're into lilacs, if you're into purple, if you want to add some lilacs to your collection, then this is definitely one that I would recommend because you basically have all you need. You have beautiful duochromes, you have beautiful mattes, you have a lot of options. You can deepen them up, and that's what I also really like about this palette. It isn't all light and lilac. This is definitely one of my favorites from Colourpop. I just love these pastel tones in here, but I just also love combining pastels with more darker shades. This is just such a nice one. Would definitely highly recommend. Then this palette I haven't officially reviewed yet on my channel. I did like a first impression get ready with me, but since then I've done a lot of looks with this one and this is just such a great palette. The shimmers in this are just amazing. They are so creamy, so pigmented. Most of them have a really nice shimmer to them as well, but they aren't too chunky. I just love this shimmer formula and I don't feel like it's anything that I've tried before. It's just so special and there's just something about it that really elevates this palette. I just I just think this formula is so great. You get a lot of options, but not a lot of redundant shades. I personally also really like that I now also have some nude shades in this formula, because I don't really have any other palettes by Glamlite. I have a lot of different options when it comes to this brand, and I immediately have a better feel for this brand. I just really enjoy this palette. Of course, these are pastels. Some of them are gonna be on the light side, but you have some options to deepen them up, and they are all quite pigmented and easy to work with. I just really enjoy this palette. If you're gonna get one pastel palette, then I would definitely recommend getting this one. It just gives you all the options. But if you're not sure if you're ever gonna wear pastel a lot, maybe don't go for such a big palette. Maybe just go for like a smaller option. But if you're quite excited about pastel, you don't really know where to start, you just want some options, then this is really a great palette. Then a palette that you might not expect to see in a video like this, but I have a very good reason to show you this one. Let me explain. So this palette, when you first look at it, it looks quite dark. It has quite a few dark shades. Listen, we have a lot of lighter shimmery shades. We have a lot of pastel here as well. Like this bottom row definitely looks more summery and pastel. We have some greens up here, some blue. We have a lot of like lighter options here. But what I really love about this palette is that I can easily deepen up more pastel looks with this one, because these darker shades, most of the time in a pastel palette, you don't have those. But I personally love deepening up a pastel look just slightly to ground it a little bit more, because sometimes it's just a little bit too light, a little bit too washed out. It's like it doesn't make the impact that I want. And here, this is all the options. Like, this is all the options for deepening up. And that's why I definitely would recommend this palette. My arm is getting tired. This is a bit of a heavy palette. So I think that's just such a great palette to combine with pastel palettes. Like, if you have this one, you have all the deepening up options, but you also have some nice shimmery toppers that you can put on top of the pastel shades that you use on the lid. I just think this really, like, elevates the look. You can really, like, get it to another level. I've just really been enjoying combining the Club Nebula palette with other more lighter palettes. It just gives you so many more options. It makes your looks a little bit more special. So you can grab the pastels from the Club Nebula palette, but you can also grab the pastels from other palettes and then combine them with these darker shades. Like, put a little bit in the outer corner, just put a little bit as like a smoky eyeliner, like a shadow eyeliner. That's what I love to do. And of course, this one is restocking in May. So if you haven't got your hands on this just yet, then keep an eye out for this palette, because it's coming back. So that was everything for the makeup. Now I also wanted to show you two little nail polishes from H&M Beauty. If you follow me on Instagram, then you might know that I'm really so excited about H&M Beauty nail polish. They just have the greatest nail polish. I really love the formula, and it's really easy to apply. It has great coverage, like you don't need too many layers. It's not too thick, not too thin, and especially with pastel nail polish, usually they don't cover up your nails the best. Like, you need a lot of layers for it to look kind of okay. Like I'm wearing this one right now. This one is called Calluna, and I only had to apply 3 layers, and it looks quite good. Like, if you look really closely, then you might be able to see like through it, but this is so much better than other pastel nail polish that I've tried. It also stays on very well, like it stays on very long, and also these nail polishes are really affordable, and at least in the Netherlands they often have sales, like 2+1 free, so then it's even more affordable. I just really wanted to mention these, because if you're like me and you have been struggling with finding pastel nail polish that really looks good on your nails, that covers your nails, and you don't need like 5-6 layers to really make it look good, definitely check out the H&M Beauty nail polishes. I just really enjoy them. Even when you're not looking for pastel nail polishes, they are just great. Then the last thing I wanted to mention in this video is a scent, a perfume. There are a lot of perfumes that I associate with this time of year, but I just feel like this one is spring in a bottle. This one is just really like fresh and sweet and fruity. It's not too sweet. It's like citrusy in a really feminine way. So it's just a really cute and fresh scent, easy to wear for every day. This is just such a nice one if you like fruity scents, but you want a little bit of sweetness in there. That's what I really like. I really love when scents are fruity but then have that little hint of sweetness. Can smell a little bit like candy. This one, it has a hint of like candy sweetness in there, but I just think it smells really nice. Let me just spray it on. It's just so sweet and fruity and fresh. It isn't too overpowering. It's definitely not like airy. So if you're looking for like a really light, fresh scent, then this wouldn't be it. But if you like fruity, if you like citrusy, but not like lemony, more like sweet citrusy, then I would definitely recommend this one. I really enjoy the H&M perfumes. They are just really affordable, they have really nice scents, they have a lot of options. When I wear this one, I just think of spring. It's just such a cute, sweet, fruity scent. So that was everything for my recommendations for spring. I hope you enjoyed seeing what my favorites are for this season. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like this video if you liked it. And don't forget to subscribe. And then I will see you in my next one. Bye bye!